Making your way in the world today takes everything you've got. Taking a break from all your worries sure would help a lot. Wouldn't you like to get away? Sometimes you wanna go where everybody knows your name, and they're always glad you came. You wanna be where you can see our troubles are all the same. You wanna be where everybody knows your name.
Yes, this is Alec Hernandez here with Angela Oliverio.
I can't believe it's already Friday. I hope that you guys remember to bring in food on Friday today to help those in need within our community.
In keeping with the giving spirit, if you're participating in Mitzvah Day tomorrow, we hope you have a wonderful time and thank you for volunteering. We know that many of you have been participating in classroom activities all week, and we can't thank you enough. It is amazing how our entire community comes together to help those in need.
It looks like it's going to be raining this weekend, so keep your umbrellas handy and stay dry. The Eagles lost against Carolina last week, which was just depressing for all Eagles fans. Hopefully they can beat the Jaguars in London this Sunday at 9:30 a.m. Go Eagles!
One of the best things about fall is Daylight Savings Time.
Oh yeah, I've heard of that, but what exactly is it?
Well, Daylight Savings Time is when the clock moves backwards an hour on November 4th. Farmers did it so that kids like us could work on the fields before they went to school. Hawaii and Alaska do not observe Daylight Savings Time. So guys, don't come to school an hour early or you might see Mr. Webb and his peaches.
Today is National Crime Fighters Day. Today we thank all of our intelligence agents, policemen, and detectives for fighting the crime in our area around the world. Did you know that today is also National Frankenstein Day?
Yeah, I just had an idea. What if the 3rd, 4th, and 5th graders did a dance about Frankenstein?
Yeah, maybe. Who knows?
Grader are going to be forming at 6 o'clock, and we're going to kick it off with a performance at the Hocus Pocus Halloween Party. Remember, 6 o'clock! See you there!
Uh-oh, zombie style! Zombie style! Watch out for walkers coming at you down the street. They're moving slowly because they're dragging all their feet. But don't be fooled, they're really not that cool.
Watch that over and over again.
Can you believe that Halloween is almost here? Here at RCS, we are really getting into the Halloween spirit. Tonight, the PTA is hosting our Hocus Pocus Halloween party from 6 to 8 in the gym. We will have games, food, music, prizes, and candy, performances from our 3rd through 5th graders, and more. And don't forget that the 8th grade is hosting the Haunted House. And not to worry, it won't be too scary for our youngest visitors. In fact, the lights will remain on for our younger friends. And for our older, more adventurous guests, the lights will be off for some extra spooky fun.
Halloween costumes are encouraged for all ages. This is sure to be a wonderful event for everyone, so please don't miss out. If you haven't already purchased your tickets, no worries. Tickets can be purchased at the door. We'll see you there. It's Flashback Friday here at RCS. Here with a recap of the events of the week that we have highlighted on social media is Kaylee Bennett.
Good morning, RCS. I'm Kaylee Bennett. Speaking of social media, have you checked out our Facebook page lately? Well, if you haven't, please do so today. If we reach 1,000 likes by the end of the school day, we will earn a free dress down day on Halloween. We are so close, so please like and share our page. Our annual fund kicked off this week to help raise much money needed for school improvements. And thanks to Clark Financial Planning, Inc., they are doubling any donations this week, up to $1,000. You have until 3 p.m. today to make a double impact with your donation. Thanks to everyone who has already donated and who is considering making a donation soon. A huge congratulations to our very own fifth grade students, John Claffey and Jake Gatoud. Over the weekend, they both received their black belts in karate. We could not be more proud of our students and their amazing achievements. And in honor of Fire Prevention Month, both our preschoolers and kindergartners were treated with special visits from local fire departments to give some hands-on demonstrations and information about fire safety. Children gained so much valuable knowledge and had so much fun.
Friends on three, 1.